everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletales. And here's the star of Tattletales, Bert Convy.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. Nice to have you with us. Boy, you've got a handlebar. That's a beauty. We're going to get a shot of that before this show's over. A fellow in the front row's got a marvelous mustache with wax on. That's terrific looking. All right, here we go. We're ready to go, I hope. Are you all ready to go? We have the blue section, the yellow section, the banana section of great fame, and the red section. And they're going to be putting their money on three wonderful celebrity couples. Truly, let's meet them, shall we? On my left, the blue section has its money on. And he's the little boy in blue today, Mr. Pat Harrington and his wife, Marge Harrington.
Yeah,
no, we don't have you. We're getting a flack out here about we don't have a fruit named for the blue section.
How about an orange that's mildew?
No, never mind. Next to Marge and Pat, the banana section, folks. The yellow section has its money on Hollywood columnist, Army Archer, and his wife, Sally.
Bananas, you mean our section has a lot of appeal, I'm sure.
Yes, that's what we meant, isn't it, gang? Oh, here we start.
No,
Selma,
gang,
how are you, love?
Mean that.
Can you hear me, Selma?
I hear you perfectly.
Okay,
Rick.
Fine. You look lovely, by the way, on the set there. Gee, it looks nice. Nice to have you both with us. Your first time on the
show.
Yes, welcome. Thank you.
Next to Selma and Army, the red section. We don't have a fruit here either. How's your money?
Hello, dear.
Hello, dear.
How you doing?
Hi, guys.
Very good. I thought you were talking to me, Bob. Hello, dear.
Well,
how are you?
You've got to watch those kind of comments on your shows. People take that very serious.
Do they really?
Yep.
Oh, I won't.
That's where the mail comes from.
Oh, boy. I'm gonna pay attention. I'm going to watch what I say. Okay. Watch what I say now as my hand reaches for the first question, and here it comes. Are you ready, gang? Ladies, it's addressed to you. It's worth $150 in the pot for your rooting sections. This is it. When you meet an attractive man, do you ever find yourself wondering what he'd be like in a romantic relationship? When you meet an attractive man, do you ever find yourself wondering what he'd be like in a romantic relationship? Think about that, ladies. We'll come back to your answer in just a moment. Bye. I guess it comes under the title of fantasizing, doesn't it, Pat?
I hope.
Yes.
Or fantasticizing.
Yeah.
What do you think about Marge?
Well, I'm positive she does. I mean, I do.
Do you?
I mean,
when you meet an attractive man, you sometimes fantasize about romantic relationships?
I'm pretty sure Margie does.
Pretty sure she fantasizes,
yes. Not too often. There aren't that many men that attract her.
Is that right?
Yes, that's right. Why do you challenge that remark?
No, I don't challenge it at all. I have no other knowledge to base that on. Let's bring her on. Hi, Marge.
Hi.
Marge.
Yes.
What's the answer? Do you find yourself sometimes wondering what it would be like in a romantic relationship?
Well, I would hope that Pat would say yes, that I do find that I... Yeah.
That's what
he said.
You're right.
Otherwise, I might as well
be
dead.
If I ever find out baby, you're in a lot of trouble.
Well, I'm a very romantic person. Actually, I have to...
Just don't talk in your sleep, Marge.
All right, okay.
You're fine. You have a share of the pot. Thank you, dear. Army, what's Selma going to say?
Well, I think, when you first sort of going with a girl and you're very jealous and you think about that a lot. But I think that, really we're so solid that I don't think that she thinks about it at all.
You don't think she ever would think about it, huh? Oh. Cover you. Now listen, you guys, he's all right.
You look like a crowd of fantasizers to me.
You're going to say that Selma doesn't fantasize when she meets an attractive man about how he'd be in a romantic relationship.
No more.
No? Okay,
no.
Let's bring her on. Hi, Selma.
Hello, Bert.
What is the answer? Do you ever wonder what it'd be like in a romantic relationship when you meet an attractive man?
It's a long answer. I have to give it to you.
Oh.
Yes, I do, and they always come up wanting.
The banana section was right, but Army wasn't on that one.
What did he say?
Tell her what you said, Army.
I said, no, she doesn't. It wasn't at one time I thought that you did, dear. But now you don't, do you?
I said, they always come up wanting. None of them compare to you.
Yes, right. Well, I'm sorry, dear. No score there, but don't worry. There's plenty of time.
But that's not the reason you mean
yes,
the score.
I didn't mean that either. So. Never mind, dear. Let's move
Brown,
right along.
You do well in Brown.
Okay, Bob, what's she going to say? Bob?
Absolutely not.
On the other hand...
Nevertheless,
just to play safe.
Yes.
I mean, it's an outside chance. You have to gamble along with me, folks.
Yeah, right.
I would say, to simplify it, yes.
That's about a 360-degree turn in about 4 seconds.
That's as smooth as you can do it.
On the other hand, yes. All right, she'll say yes. Let's bring on Sheila. Sheila, what is the answer now? Do you ever wonder what it'd be like to have a romantic relationship with an attractive man when you meet him?
Not anymore. I have all the romance I can handle.
I love you, dear.
I
love
you.
That really was, they're very angry with us, but you really, that's very nice. Thank you, dear.
That's not what the man said. I'm
you
sorry,
are,
Sheila. That means the only ones that got a right to march at Pat Harrington, they get the whole $150. Let's give it to them. To see who gets the rest of these spots in just a minute. Please come back to me, won't you?